We want to divide a decimal by another decimal. The first step in these problems will be to write this as a long division problem. So we'll have 18.2 divided by 0.4. Now we saw in the previous video that dividing a decimal by a whole number is a pretty straightforward process. We move the decimal point up into the quotient, and then we divide as we normally would. Now the reason I mention that is what we're going to do is manipulate this to make our divisor a whole number. And we can do that by moving the decimal point one place to the right. Notice how now we would be dividing by 4. And we can make this move as long as we move the decimal point in our dividend as well. So we'll take this decimal point and move it to the right one place to here. So now we've changed the division problem to 182 divided by 4, where the decimal point would now be here after the 2, which we would then move up into our quotient. Now let's briefly talk about why this procedure works. If we consider a much easier problem like, let's say, 10 divided by 2, we know 10 divided by 2 is equal to 5. We also know that the decimal point for 2 is here and here for 10. So if we move the decimal point one place to the right on 2, it would be here, making this 20. And if we move it to the right one place for 10, this would be 100. So the new division problem would be 100 divided by 20. And notice how the quotient is still 5. So every time you move the decimal point to the right one place, we're really just multiplying the divisor and dividend by 10. Let's go ahead and perform this division now. We first want to determine how many 4s there are in 18. That would be 4. 4 times 4 is 16. We subtract, that would be 2. Bring down the next digit. So now we want to know how many 4s there are in 22. That would be 5. 5 times 4 is 20. We subtract. We have a remainder of 2, but we don't want to use remainder notation when we're working with decimals. So we want to bring down another digit. And the way we do this is we add a 0 to the right here, which is adding a 0 to the tenths place value, which does not change the value of 182. So now we can bring this 0 down and ask how many 4s there are in 20, which would be 5. 5 times 4 is 20. We subtract. And now that we have a difference of 0, we're done. So the answer, or the quotient, to the original problem involving decimals is the same as this quotient here, 45.5, or 45 5/10. Let's go ahead and try a second example. We have 5.112 divided by 1.42. So the first step is to move the decimal in our divisor to make this a whole number. So in this problem, we'll have to move it two places to the right. So we'll have to do the same in our dividend. 1, 2. And just so it's easy to read, let's go ahead and rewrite this. We're going to have 511.2 divided by 142. And this quotient will be the same as the quotient to the given problem. And now we'll move the decimal point up into our quotient and divide as we normally would. So we want to determine how many 142s are in 511. Not an easy question. I think it's going to be 3. So 3 times 2 is 6. 3 times 4 is 12. Carry the 1. 3 times 1 plus 1, that's going to be 426. And now we need to subtract. This difference is equal to 85, which is less than 142, so this 3 is correct. We'll bring down the next digit, which is the 2. And now we need to determine how many 142s there are in 852. Again, not an easy question. Let's try 6. 6 times 2 is 12, carry a 1. 6 times 4 is 24 plus 1, that's 25, carry a 2. 6 times 1 plus 2 is 8, so that worked out perfectly. This difference is 0. We have no remaining digits, so we're done. This quotient is equal to 3.6, or 3 6/10, which would be the quotient to the given division problem as well.